I know I keep saying I record in other places, and I do, but every once in a while, things happen that I will leave here out in the open. I wonder if anyone will find where I hide the other videos. Well, there's somebody that will, because I'm seeing to it after I'm gone, shall we say. But anyway, the reason I'm posting on the main blog today, two stories, and I don't want them to be lost in the ethers. Anybody that remembers me talking about a dog mom and dad had, a basset hound by the name of Oscar, dad called him Dooley, up in Magnolia, or Pinehurst, outside of Pinehurst where they live. And when I came back from a road trip, some play I was in, I stayed with him for a while, and Dooley loved to bay at distant trains and would just sing his heart out. And for fun one time, I started to try to sing with him, and he did not like this at all. Every time I would sing along, he would shut up and look up at the window like, how dare you interrupt this concert? And if I kept it up, he would drop his ears and slink off to a doghouse. So it was a lot of fun to listen to Dooley sing, and he did not appreciate my accompaniment. Well, Doodles, my rescue almost Labrador, has taken that up in the last couple of years of singing along with passing trains, or ambulances, actually. It's ambulances that she goes for. And unfortunately, she can't hear me. She doesn't have a very good voice at all. It cracks. It warbles. It's just awful. And it just brings me to laughing tears. Now, if I try to sing along with her, she doesn't care. But if I laugh at her, she gets highly offended and does slinks off like she's done something wrong. And so I can't laugh at her, and yet it's the most hilarious thing you've ever seen. Well, adding to this now long history, from the very pen she was rescued from, there are now two little tiny white, well, not one's not so tiny, but they're white poodles, and they're being kept in there. They're being kept in a lot better conditions than Doodles was, so I haven't raised any stink about it, but they don't clean the pen, in my opinion, often enough. But anyway, those poor little babies stay out there a lot. But the feisty one, the smallest one of the two, I guess she thinks she has to be feisty because she's small, has taken up Doodle's habit of singing along with ambulances. And of course, that is even funnier, to hear this tiny, tinny, soulful-sounding, trying to be soulful-sounding, little voice coming out of this little teeny white poodle. So that's the Intervale report. There's an awful lot of fun sounds emanating from Intervale these days, and it pleases me greatly. One of my joys of being here. The other piece that I wanted to talk about in this is not so much fun. Someone that I know quite well, known for a long time, a voiceover actor by the name of Mike Kleindienst. Mike, quiet guy, handsome, about, well, exactly my age. Former football player, wonderful voiceover actor, very quiet though, but just pleasant. Everybody liked Mike. He died of a heart attack this last Friday, and I didn't know it until I read the obit, something you start to do in your mid to late 50s. We had the exact same birthday, November 14th, 1951. He's in great shape, does all the right things, keels over with a heart attack. Makes you think. I really enjoy my time here, and I don't take it for granted. And I want to spend it with those that I care about. I'm sitting here all looking ugly because I just came in from mowing the yard, one of my least favorite things in the world, but got to be done. But that's why I put on another shirt, and I'm still sweating on it. But that's the Intervale report, and it's ironic that a guy born exact same day I was, a lot better shape than I, he's gone. Time's short. Enjoy it.